At some point in your imaging workflow, you should consider cropping. Cropping can serve a technical need, making sure that the image is sized specifically for a screen or a frame or an output device. And it can also serve as an artistic decision, allowing you to choose what parts of the image are shown and which are hidden. There are many reasons to crop, and it's very easy to do so inside of Aurora HDR. To access cropping, just click on the Crop tool up top. Now, if you are doing anything else like the masking we were doing earlier, make sure you click the Done button to store the changes. Now, what you can do is click on the Crop tool. You'll see the Crop image overlay. On the left-hand side here are several useful presets. Essentially, this allows you to always force it to the original aspect ratio of the camera, or to flip it like you were shooting vertical in the camera, or we have the ability to choose specific sizes. You'll notice here, for example, there's a laptop screen, 16:9 for televisions, a printed piece of paper, or common photographic sizes. Perhaps a square for social media, or some sizes here for a Facebook cover graphic or a feed. Or of course, you can enter a custom size as well. Let's go with a 7:5, and I'll start to adjust my crop. You'll notice that you cannot crop beyond the edge of the photo. But as you adjust here, it will show you what's possible. And in this case, for a true 7:5, I may have to get rid of some of the top or the bottom of the image. I'm going to favor showing more of the foreground here and lose the top of the window. Additionally, as you work, you have the ability, if needed, to click and rotate. As long as the cropping dialog is smaller than the window, this can be quite useful if you have a problem such as a crooked line. Here, a little bit of rotation, even though I attempted to fix this earlier, allows me to potentially correct an image that's not perfectly straight. You'll also notice the ability here for different overlays. One popular choice is to use the rule of thirds grid to help place a key subject. That can be quite useful as you drag. Or we have another option here for the golden mean. As you work, you can also easily transform the image. These may vary depending upon which version of Aurora HDR you're using, but this can give you the ability to flop the image one direction or the other, or to flip the top and bottom, or rotate a certain number of degrees. All in all, very useful. When you click Done, the Crop tool will update. And if you go back into cropping, you'll notice that it did not actually discard the image. What this means is that if you take the time to save a native Aurora file, and you crop for a specific size, maybe you need a 5:7 print, well, the next time you open up your document, you can recrop to another size and completely change it. This means that you're not actually permanently cropping or discarding pixels. They're there inside the native source file. This is incredibly flexible and allows you to make many different sizes for multiple outputs that are very common in a modern digital workflow that also involves printing and many different digital devices.